Hello everyone! In this video, I want to talk about CSG objects or CSG shapes, as they are called in Godot. And CSG stands for Constructive Solid Geometry. And if you have made a Godot project yourself, then you might have noticed these notes here that you can add to your scene that all start with CSG. So what does this stand for really? What does constructive solid geometry really mean? In order to show that, I've made this little example scene here. And this is basically showing you that you can have different objects and apply them together in order to create more complex objects from them. So let's take this CSG box here, which is set to the operation union. And if I move that one out, you see that in truth, it is just a normal cube. That's all that is defined in this object. However, if I add to this object a similar cube with the operation subtraction, and by adding I mean move it to roughly the same area as the other cube, then you will see that the cube will change its shape according to where the subtraction box is. There is also the intersection, which means that instead of showing you the area of the cube that is not affected by the subtraction, you get only the area of both cubes where they intersect towards each other. So it basically, one shows the hollow side of a cube, so a cube with a hollow interior, and by intersecting, by using intersection instead of subtraction, you get the inside of a cube as a not hollow area instead, but not the outside area of a cube, basically. And by using these three operations accordingly, you can create prototypes for your level if you don't have the according assets yet, or create complex shapes inside Godot and use them in your final game if you want to. And yeah, you can make, for example, a level by, let's say, adding a wall to this room, like so. We just add another cube with a union operation here. And if we want to have a hole in this wall in order for our character to pass through, we just add another CSG object. This time around I use the cylinder. Apply the subtraction to it and drop it in the same area as our wall, and now we have a hole in the wall that our character could theoretically pass through if we program this accordingly. So the last thing I want to show you in this video are these CSG container or combiner, as they are called. And with the way the CSG objects work is that they are basically like doing math calculations, like subtraction, addition, multiplication, that sort of stuff. You can sort of think of it that way. So they operate always on two objects. In this case, for example, our box interacts with our second box, and by doing so, we get our result, which in this case is that from the initial box that we have, all the area of that box, we subtract a part of the area that we have defined in our second box. And as the result, we get the remaining volume of our box, of our original box. And our combiners are basically a way to tell that objects belong together, and afterward operations should be applied accordingly. So as you can see, our combiner here also has the ability to be either a union or an intersection or subtraction operation. So those combiners you can sort of think of as parentheses in math, basically giving you a structure of what should be combined first, and that you want to use the result of that afterwards for additional operations that you want to have happened on those elements. So yeah, this is a little introduction into the topic of using CSG for your game. But because it is a very visual component in Godot, I would recommend you try this out yourself. And I think you will very fast get the hang of it once you have used it yourself. If you haven't fully understand it yet, that's not a problem at all. Just try it out and you'll see it's not very difficult to understand once you are using this yourself. So yeah, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, bye bye.